This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through Patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Topic 3. Change of base value in per-unit systems. Part 3A. In the previous topics, we introduced per-unit systems and discussed their advantages in detail. In this topic, we will be discussing a crucial aspect of per-unit system, that is the changes in base value. In this video, Part 3A, we will derive a formula that will come handy in complex analysis of power systems. Until now, we have looked into examples and problems that involve a single base value for the entire power system. But what if the different regions in the power systems have varying base values? For example, the generator side would be working on 200 MVA base power, the transmission line has a base power of 50 MVA, and the base power of the load side is 100 MVA. Such type of power systems require the selection of one base for the whole system and also require conversion of different bases to the selected one. And the same goes for the other quantities involved. We know that when we convert a power system into per unit equivalents, we find out per unit impedances according to the selected base value. Now we will derive the formula for calculating a per unit impedance if the selected base value is different from the given one. The general formula that is used to calculate per unit impedance is this. Z per unit is equal to the Z actual impedance divided by the Z base impedance. We know that the actual impedance remains the same no matter what the base is. So by rearranging the above equations, we get Z actual is equal to Z per unit times Z base. For a given base value, we can write the equation as Z actual is equal to Z per unit given times Z base given. If we want to calculate the per unit impedance according to a new base value, we can then write the formula as this. Z per unit new is equal to the Z actual divided by Z base new. And that is equal to Z per unit given times Z base given divided by Z base new. From our previous videos, we know that the base impedance is equal to the base voltage squared divided by the base power. So Z base given is equal to V base given squared divided by S base given. And Z base new is equal to V base new squared divided by S base new. Putting this equation to find out Z per unit new, what we get is this. Z per unit new is equal to Z per unit given multiplied by Z base given squared divided by S base given. And the whole thing divided by V base new squared over S base new. Rearranging the above equations, we get this. Z per unit new is equal to Z per unit given times V base given squared divided by V base new squared times S base new over S base given. So finally, we have derived a complete formula that will aid us in tackling various bases in power system. We can use this formula to calculate new per unit impedances and hence make a per unit equivalent model of a power system. Now in the next video, we will solve an example from a book that incorporates the above formula so that we can have a clear concept in our minds. We hope you have a continued interest in this topic and series. As a student or professional, we also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to GeneralPack.com and becoming our patron at Patreon.com/GeneralPack. Thank you.